No. Hey, kids. How's it going? What am I doing here? Oh, I'm getting out my old building blocks. I've had these since I was what a wee little lad. A lot of good memories with these building blocks. In fact, I apparently colored on a whole lot of them. I'm not sure what was going on when I played this day, but I wrote Nash Empire on one. Several of them have the Superman S on them. So I've had a problem my entire life, apparently. And this one apparently has a clock on it. And I know what I was playing when I made that. I was reenacting Back to the Future, which that's a discussion for another time. But I thought today would be a great day to build something with my blocks. How many of you love building blocks? What do you enjoy building? Man, those are some fantastic ideas. I think today I'm going to keep it real simple. I think I'm just going to build a nice small house. Nothing over the top. Just 5 stories, wraparound porch, a nice steep slanted roof. Yeah, I think that's a great idea. Shouldn't take me too long to build either. How about this? I'll start the music. I do better building when I have music that I'm able to listen and sing along with. And you can sing and dance to the music as I'm building. And when we come back, we'll see how things are going. Great. Here we go.
Darkness tremble, Jesus, Jesus.
house. It's made out of bricks. It's gonna be real tall and really cool. I'm just gonna keep on building my house of bricks. I'll keep on going, just building. Billy Goat McGruff. Oh, hey kids, welcome back. I'm having a lot of difficulty with the house here. Every time I try to make it taller, it falls over. I'm not sure what the problem is. I mean, these are really good, sturdy, solid, wooden bricks here. It should stay standing up. What? The pillow's the problem? Oh, no. You're just not getting the picture here, the vision for this house. It's going to be a house floating on water. That's cool, right? Because it's blue. Oh, you're saying because the pillow is not flat and it's not sturdy that every time it gets touched, it falls over. Ah, very smart, kiddos. Very, very smart. Maybe if I build on a flat surface that's solid and doesn't move so much, I'll have an easier time. I'll try that. But all this building has reminded me of a parable that Jesus told. A parable is a story that's simple and easy to understand, but teaches a very important truth. Jesus would tell parables quite often to the crowds that followed him around so that they could more easily understand God, how much God loves them, and the kingdom of heaven. In this particular parable, we are told about two builders who are building a house, and each one goes about it in a different way. Let's watch the video, and then we'll talk about it.
This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like walking on water.
Oh, hey guys.
And even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
One day, as he saw the crowds gathering, Jesus went up to the mountainside and sat down. His disciples gathered around him, and he began to teach them. He asked them, "Why do you keep calling me Lord, Lord, when you don't do what I say? Anyone who listens to my teaching and follows it is wise."
Hey, I'm gonna build here.
I'm gonna build out there.
All right, suit yourself.
Like a person who builds a house on solid rock.
Oh, yeah.
When the floodwaters rise and break against that house, it stands firm because it was well built.
All good here.
But anyone who hears my teaching and doesn't obey it is foolish.
All right, hey, it's nice.
Like a person who builds a house on sand.
Uh-oh.
When the rains and floods come and the winds beat against that house, it will collapse with a mighty crash. When Jesus had finished saying these things, the crowds were amazed at his teaching.
Jesus compared hearing God's word to two guys building houses. The one who hears God's word and obeys it is very wise, like a man building his house on a solid foundation. The man who hears God's word and does not obey it is foolish, like a guy building his house on sand or on a pillow, in our case. And for each person, when the storm comes, and the storm is difficulty, it's when life gets hard. It's when we're going through a bad time. It's temptations that we go through. The wise man will be able to handle the storm. It won't knock over his house as easily. But for the foolish builder who built his house on sand, when that storm comes, everything can come crashing down. The thing we need to understand is that even when we have Jesus in our heart, life will still be hard. We will still go through these difficult times. We'll still have storms in our life. But when we make Jesus our firm foundation, When our life is built on him, we will be better able to get through those difficult times. And I don't know about you, but that brings a lot of joy to my heart, knowing that even in the bad times, Jesus is with me and will help me get through it. How about we pray and say thank you that Jesus is always with us? Dear Lord, we love you and we are so very thankful that you are with us no matter what. For all the storms that we go through, all the bad times, you are with us. I pray for these kids, Lord, who would hear your word and that they would practice living it in their life, God, that they would strive to love you and to love others as you ask us to do. I pray, God, that their life would be built on this firm foundation. We thank you for everything. Let it be in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Well, kids, I think I'm going to keep building my house here. I'm pretty happy with how it turned out. And of course, I have a Superman topper for the front door there. I hope you all have a great week, and I'll talk to you again soon.